say. See, yesterday we discussed UFT tool architecture incomplete. First we discussed add-in manager, next UFT tool editor, third one active screen, next data table. Data table. What is data table? Have any idea? What is data table in UFT?
There is a data table at the bottom, like Excel sheet, where you when you want to parameterize any.
Ah, yes, yes. See, it is not Excel. Excel like. Okay, it is an integrated spreadsheet for data related operations. It is an integrated spreadsheet for data related operations. See, using data table we can work with flat files, Excel files and database files. See, using data table we can work with flat files, Excel files and database files. Any database. Suppose without using data table, I want to perform data related operations without using data table. Is there any possibility? Tell me. I want to work with flat files, Excel files and database files without using UFT tool feature data table. What is the alternate?
You can do like read, like reading the Excel file or flat file. Like create object.
Yes, create objects using, say, using VB script. Using VB script automation objects. Using VB script automation objects, same we can work with flat files, database files, Excel files, file system object, Excel application object, database connection object and database record set objects are there. Okay, data table. How to launch data table? Navigation. View menu. View menu. Data. View menu. Data. Next, it has two sheets, two types of sheets, not two sheets, two types of sheets. See, it has two types of sheets. What are they? One is global sheet. Global sheet for entire test, all actions in the test for entire test. Another is action sheets, one or more. If it is one action, only one action sheet. If it is multiple actions, multiple action sheets. Action sheets. Or you can say local sheets for specific actions. Action sheets are local sheets. See, anyhow, in data driven testing chapter, I will show the practical. Now only theory level, what is what. Just a minute. Take new test. Just a minute. Next, view menu, data. See, some installation problem is there. Just a minute. Quit the tool. Launch the tool once again. New test. View data. It is not showing. Just a minute. See, some compatibility issue. Observe left side bottom. How many sheets? Two sheets. Global action one. Suppose if I create one more action, then observe at left side bottom. How many action sheets? Two sheets.
Two sheets.
Two sheets. See. See, it has two types of sheets, global and local. Next point, UFT attaches one data table for every new test. It is test level feature. Suppose if we create 100 tests in our project, UFT attaches 100 data tables. You use, don't use, that is secondary. It attaches one data table for every new test. UFT attaches one data table for every new test. Suppose 10 tests. 10 data tables. Next, one more point. Data table located in two areas. One is design time data table area, EFT tool main window. Another location, EFT tool result window. Their name is runtime data table. Runtime data table, nothing but carbon copy of design time data table. What is the purpose of runtime data table? That we will discuss in practical chapter. See, data table located in two areas. One is in AFT main window. Main window. Another location in AFT result window. See, in main window, name is design time data table. Design time data table. In result window, runtime data table. Next important point, usage of data table. How to use? Usage of data table. See, we have four types of usage. First usage, enter test data directly into data table and connect to the test. See, test is different, test data is different. We have to connect test data with the test. Enter test data into data table and connect. Second usage, see, just a minute. See, a data table is there. Here you can enter test data directly. Otherwise, import from file, import from database. Import from external files, files available on hard disk. Import from external files, import test data from external files and connect. See, connecting to the test is mandatory for every usage. Here files, generally we use text files, means flat files or Excel files. Next, third one, import test data from databases, any database, and connect. Import test data from a database and connect. Next, fourth usage, hybrid usage. We can insert programmatic statements. Hybrid usage, tool feature with programmatic statements. Why we use programmatic features, programmatic statements with tool features? See, already we discussed tool features. Tool features are ready-made. Tool features are ready-made. They may have so many drawbacks, limitations. In order to overcome limitations, not all limitations, some limitations. In order to overcome some limitations of tool features, we insert programmatic statements. Getting this point?
Yes, sir.
What are the limitations of data table that we will discuss in practical chapter? Just remember the concept. Fourth one, hybrid approach. What is the hybrid approach? Data table methods and see using data table methods and programmatic statements. Programmatic statements. See one small note. We insert programmatic statements in order to overcome some limitations of tool features. Not all limitations, some limitations. Scripting logic, programming logic doesn't have any limitations, but tool features, ready-made, have some limitations. See, we insert programmatic statements like conditional statements, loop statements, etc. in order to overcome some limitations of tool features. See, this is a brief introduction about data table. See, 4-5 points we discussed regarding data table. Tell me, what is data table? What is data table?
Data table is an integrated spreadsheet for data related operations.
Next. It has two types of sheets, na?
Yeah, it has two types of global and action sheet.
Action sheets. If it is one action, one sheet. If it is 10 actions, 10 sheets. Okay. Mm-hmm. Next, you have to attach one data table for every new test. It is not tool level feature. Test level feature. Mm-hmm. Suppose in our project 50 tests, 50 data tables. Okay. Yeah. Next, data table located in two areas. What are they?
Data table
located in two areas.
Oh, navigation?
Not navigation. Navigation is different. Data table located in two areas. One is in main window. Here name is design time data table. Another area in EFT tool result window, their name is runtime data table, nothing but carbon copy of design time data table. Mm-hmm. Okay, next, use important one, usage of data table. I have explained four types of usage. What are they?
Enter test data into data table.
Enter test data directly into data table without any mediator. Directly into data table and connect it to the test. Next.
Import test data from external file.
Text files or Excel files. Next, third one.
Import test data from database.
Next, fourth one, hybrid.
For programmatic statements.
Using data table methods and programmatic statements. See, this is the brief introduction about data table. Anyhow, in data driven testing chapter, once again I will explain and show the practical. Next key element of UFT tool, information pane. What is information? It shows syntax errors, not runtime errors, syntax errors automatically while saving the test. See, it shows syntax errors automatically while saving the test. Otherwise, you can launch using View menu. View menu. Say. Just a minute. Remove this if. Try to save the test. Observe. Showing errors now. See, actually, this information pane in QTP last version 11, in this EFT, name is errors pane. Errors. What is errors pane? What is errors? It shows syntax errors.
Okay.
It shows syntax errors while saving the test. Otherwise, you can launch errors pane using view menu. Suppose try to save the test, showing. Otherwise, go to view menu, errors. Okay. See, next, put mute. See, I will introduce all 12 menus of EFT tool. Actually, why we need to familiar with all menu items? In certification exam, EFT certification exam, they ask questions only on EFT tool features. No questions on VB script. But in real time, most of the time we use VB script. But in certification, they ask questions only on EFT tool features. They highlight their product only. So in order to take that EFT certification exam, you need to familiar with all tool features. See, but in real time, 25 to 30% features only useful. Remaining features, alternate features, some unnecessary features also there. But for certification exam, you need to familiar with maximum tool features. See. UFT commands. UFT commands. Say, here record is command. Record is command. Record. Run is command. Stop is command. All these are UFT commands. UFT commands available in three ways. In three ways, we can use UFT commands. First way, as menu items. Menu items. Next, as toolbar. Toolbar items. Next, third one, as shortcut keys. Shortcut keys. Say, shortcut keys only for some important commands, but menu items and toolbar items for all commands. Suppose I want to suppose I am taking new test. I want to start recording. For that I can use menu item, record menu, record command. Otherwise, here red symbol is there. Toolbar item. This is also record command. Otherwise, we can use F6 shortcut key. Isn't it?
Yes.
Say
Yes.
you have take commands available in three ways: menu items, the toolbar items, and shortcut keys. Shortcut keys only for some important commands. Menu bar, menu items, toolbar items for all commands. Suppose I want to start recording. Here, record menu, record command. Otherwise, here toolbar item record. Otherwise, you can directly use F6 shortcut key. Okay, I will introduce all 12 menus of EFT tool. EFT tool menus. Total 12 menus. QTP last version, QTP 11. In that QTP 11 only 10 menus. In EFT 12 menus. They redesigned the user interface also. See, first menu of EFT. What is the first menu of EFT? File menu. See, what are the important commands available in this file menu? What are the important commands? Using this file menu, we can create new test. Next, open existing test. Next, add test. See, using this add test command, we can open multiple tests at a time. This facility is not available in QTP last version. See, observe. Now test name 7, GUI test 7. Suppose I want to open one more, add new test. Now how many tests opened in this editor?
One. Four.
No.
Eight. One.
How many tests opened? Two tests, GUI test 7, GUI test 8. See, in GUI test 7, one action, in GUI test 8, one action. You can create multiple actions also. Getting? Any confusion?
Yes, with that. I thought these are four tests.
See, action is part of test na. For example, I want to create multiple actions in this GUI test. Select GUI test 7. GUI test 7 design, call to new action, action 2. Just a minute. Just a minute, I will show names also. First test name, login. Login. Select login test, three actions. Now tell me how many tests? How many tests?
Test three actions.
Only one test?
Yes.
Only one test, but the test having three actions. Okay, one or more actions, forget about it. Next, add test, new test. This test is register. It has only one action. Now total how many tests?
Yes.
Two tests.
Register and login.
Yes, register and login. First test login having three actions. Second test only one action. Okay. See, using this add test feature, we can open multiple tests at a time in EFT tool editor. See, add test. Using this command, we can open multiple tests at a time in EFT tool editor. See, this feature not available in QTP last version. See, using this file menu, we can create new test, open existing test, add test, next, save. Save test, next, important commands. Close test, next. Here, one settings feature available. Using this settings, we can associate all resource files to EFT except shared object repositories, remaining resources. Using settings feature, we can associate resource files What are the files? Associate function, library files, one or more. Next, associate recovery. Recovery scenario files, one or more. Next, associate environment variable files. Environment variables files. Getting this point? Settings feature. What is the purpose of settings feature in file menu?
To associate function library, recovery scenario and environment variable.
First of all, why we need to associate resource files to EFT? Why?
For a function to regular use of the same test over and over again, we create
Say, suppose you created some 100 functions in a library file. If you want to use those functions in your tests, if you want to access external functions, user-defined functions, first you need to associate that library file, then you can use them. Suppose if you want to use environment variables in your tests, first associate environment variables file and use. Suppose if you want to use recovery scenarios in your tests, first associate recovery scenario files and use. Next, export test. Export test to zip file. See, sometimes in certification exam they ask, what is the supporting format for exporting EFT tests? A, ZIP, B, ISO, C, RAR, like options. Next, import test from ZIP. Next, exit command. Using exit command, we can quit EFT tool. Quit the tool. See, these are the important commands in file menu. Observe file. New, open, add, close, save. Settings. Using settings feature. In practical chapters, I will show how to associate. Resource, associate. Associate library files. Here. Environment variables file. Here, recovery scenario files. Next, last one. Export test to ZIP, import test to ZIP, import test from ZIP, exit. Now tell me, what is file menu? What are the important commands available in file menu? Quick, then we will move to next menu, edit menu.
Create new test, open existing test, add test,
save test.
Save test, close text, and then on settings they have like associate functional library, recovery scenario files and environment variables.
Files. Next, one more feature is there, export test to ZIP and import test from ZIP. Last command?
Exit.
Exit. Quit the tool. See, next. See, edit command, edit menu, see in this menu you can find editor commands, see, redo, undo, see in MS Word also you can find editor commands. Cut. Copy. Paste. Delete. Etc. Next, one more feature is there. Format. Using this format feature, we can add comments. We can make block of statements as comment. And uncomment, block of statements as comments, next uncomment comment block, next code snippet feature is there. Using this code snippet feature, we can generate conditional and loop statement syntax. VB script conditional and loop statements. See, edit menu, format, see, comment, uncomment, etc. Next, code snippet. Using code snippet feature, we can generate VB script conditional statements and loop statements. See, suppose do while loop. Just a minute. Suppose if. And one more thing, using edit menu you can generate VB script conditional statements and loop statements syntax. Otherwise you can type directly. Suppose I want for loop. Just type for space, see, automatically generated. Next, I want if condition. Type if space, generated. Now tell me what is this one? Edit menu.
Cut, copy, paste, undo, snippets.
Code snippet. What is the
code
purpose
snippet.
Of code snippet feature?
And to the VBScript command automatically generates if you
not VBScript, all commands. VBScript conditional and loop statement syntax.
Practice conditional and loop statement in syntax.
See, edit menu. In this edit menu, we can find editor commands. Redo, undo, cut, copy, paste, delete, etc. And format feature is there. Using format feature, we can format the text. Comment, uncomment, intend, etc. Next, code snippet feature is there. Using code snippet feature, we can generate VBScript conditional and loop statement syntax. Otherwise, we can type directly. See, to generate VBScript conditional and loop statements. Next, third menu, view menu. See, using this view menu, you can launch UFT key elements called data table. Next, active screen. Next, errors pane. You can launch using view menu. We can launch data table, active screen, errors pane. Next, debug pane. Next, we can view the test flow. Test flow. Suppose in our test, 7 actions. What is the sequence? Using test flow, you can watch the sequence of actions. Next, switch from editor view to keyword view. And vice versa. Next, launch result window. Etc. Say, view menu. Using view menu, you can launch data table, output pane, errors pane, active screen, debug pane. Next, switch to keyword view and vice versa. Next, run last run results. Etc. Tell me what is view menu?
View menu, data table, active screen, debug, error, switch to keyword view and vice versa, test flow, launch result window.
Yes, etc. Yes. Okay, next fourth one, simple menu, search menu. Search menu. See, in this search menu you can find search commands. Find next replace, next incremental search, next reverse incremental search, etc. See, find next, replace incremental, reverse incremental, bookmarks, go to, etc. Next, fifth menu, important menu, design menu. Design menu. See, in this menu you can find action commands and insertion items. See, action commands: create new action, next call to existing action, next copy action, etc. Next, insertion items. Using this menu we can insert checkpoints, next insert output values, next insert transaction points, next insert synchronization point, next launch step generator. Step generator in creating test chapter I will show practical. It is used to generate recordable and non-recordable steps. Next, launch function definition generator. Etc. See, important menu, design menu. See, design, call to new action, call to copy of action, call to existing action, insert checkpoints, output values, launch step generator, next launch function definition generator, insert transaction points, start, end, next synchronization point, etc. Tell me, what is design menu? What are the important commands available in design menu?
Insert transaction point. Create new action, call action, copy action, insert checkpoints, insert output value, insert transaction, synchronization point, launched step generator.
Next, function definition generator. Okay, see, once again, using design menu we can create new action, call to existing action, copy action, next insert checkpoints, output values, transaction points, synchronization point, next launch step generator, launch function definition generator, etc. Next, sixth menu, record menu. Record menu. See, in this record menu you can find record commands. See, record stop, not stop, I think. Stop also there. Record. Record means normal recording. Record, just a record means normal recording. Next, stop. Next, other recording modes. Analog recording. Next, low level recording. Next, insight recording. Insight recording. Next, record and run settings, etc. See, record, stop, analog, low level, inside, record and run settings. Tell me what is record menu in EFT tool main window?
Record, stop, analog, low level, inside, and record and settings.
Okay. See, in QTP last version 11.0, only three recording modes. Normal recording, analog recording, and low level recording. In EFT, one mode added, four recording modes. Normal recording, analog recording, low level recording, and insight recording. Okay, next, seventh menu, run menu. Run menu. See, in this run menu we can find normal run commands and debug commands. Run, pause, I think stop command available as in this also. Stop, continue, etc. Normal run commands. Next, debug commands for step by step execution. Normal commands for at a time execution. Debug commands for step by step execution. Here, important debug commands: step over, step out, next, insert or remove, breakpoints, etc. See, run, pause, stop, compile, next, step into, step over, step out, insert or remove breakpoints, clear all breakpoints, etc. Next, run modes also available. Tell me what is run menu?
Run, pause, stop, continue, step over.
Step into, step over, step out, insert or remove breakpoints, clear all breakpoints, etc. Okay. Next menu, important menu, resources menu. See. Resources menu. See, in this resources menu you can find two types of commands. One is object repository commands, another recovery scenario commands. Using resource menu, we can launch object repository object repository. Next, edit local objects. Next, create shared repository. See, object repository two types, local, shared, that we will discuss in object repository chapter. Local repository, recording uses local repository. Keyword driven methodology uses shared repository. Create shared repository. Next, edit shared objects. Next, associate shared repositories, one or more. Next, create new recovery scenario. Create new recovery scenario for error handling. Next, edit existing recovery scenario. Etc. See, observe resources menu, object repository, object, using object repository you can launch object repository. Next, we can edit local objects. Next, using object repository manager, we can create and edit shared objects. Next, associate repositories. Next, recovery scenario manager. Using recovery scenario manager, we can create and edit recovery scenarios. Tell me, what is resources menu? Important menu.
Object. Launch object repository, create shared repository, associate shared repository, create new recovery scenario, edit local object, edit exit.
Okay, see. Using resources menu, we can launch object repository, edit local objects, create shared repository, edit shared objects, associate shared object repositories. Next, create new recovery scenario. Next, edit existing recovery scenario. See, next menu, ALM, Application Lifecycle Management, ALM. See, if you integrate EFT with ALM, ALM tool, you can use this menu. See, ALM connection, by providing username and password, you can connect to ALM project. ALM connection, check out to check in, see. ALM connection, check out, check in, version history, baseline history, etc. Okay, baseline history, etc. See, next menu, important menu, tools menu. Tools menu. See, in this menu, you can find configurable items. Already we discussed, you take any software, you can find two types of features. Constant features, next configurable features. See, using this menu, we can configure object identification. Next, we can launch object spy. Next, virtual object configuration. Next, data driver wizard available in this menu. Using data driver, we can connect test data to the test. Data driver. Next, a regular expression evaluator for search operations. Regular expression evaluator. Next, using this tools menu, we can configure view options. Next, tool options, etc. See, object spy, object identification, regular expression evaluator, data driver, virtual object. Next, options. Here, tool options, view options available. Next, window menu. See, in this menu, no functionality, only next window, previous window, close all documents. Simple menu. Window menu. In this menu, next window, previous window, close all open documents, all tests, close all documents. See, next window, previous window, close all documents. Next, last menu of UFT, last menu, help menu. In this menu, you can find UFT tool features documentation, UFT tool features documentation. Next, VBScript documentation. Next, new features information. Next, knowledge forums. Next, you can check for updates, product updates. Next, if you have a licensed version, you can raise tickets directly from this menu. technical support. You can get technical support if you have licensed version. See, no technical support for trial versions. Next, product information. Next, license info, etc. See help menu. UFT help, forums, what is new, update. See product information, license information. Okay. Okay, now this is about EFT tool menus. All 12 menus of EFT tool. Okay. Hello. Any queries?
No queries, sir. Okay. No queries.
Cool, cool. See. So far we completed first one, overview on UFT chapter, overview on UFT. In this chapter we discussed UFT product information, UFT version history, UFT license, UFT add-ins, UFT supporting environments and UFT IDE. Next, UFT test process, roadmap for our program. In this chapter we discussed all 6 phases of UFT: test planning, generating basic tests, enhancing tests, running and debugging tests, analyzing test results and reporting defects. Next, UFT tool window architecture. In this chapter, we discussed key elements of UFT tool, add-in manager, UFT tool editor, active screen, data table, errors pane. Next, all 12 menus of UFT tool. Next, as per our roadmap, UFT test process, first phase planning. But in real time, first planning, then generating tests and enhancing tests, executing tests, etc. First planning, then test design, then test execution, then analyzing results, reporting defects. But in our training program, first we will discuss, we will postpone that planning phase at end of the program. Why? After discussing all concepts only, you can cope up for planning phase. But in real time, planning first. But in our training program, we will discuss planning phase at end of the program. Postpone the planning phase. Next phase. What is the next phase? What is the next phase in UFT test process? First planning. Okay.
Execution.
Before design, how can you execute? Don't confuse. Before test design, how can you execute? Hello?
Yes, no.
See,
I got confused, sorry.
Don't confuse. In UFT test process, first phase test planning. We postponed that phase. Why? Because after learning on concepts, all concepts only, you can cope up for that phase. But in real time, first phase test planning only. Okay. Mm-hmm. Test plan, test planning phase postponed. What is the next phase?
Design.
Generating. Put mute. Generating basic tests. See, here we have 2 methods for generating basic tests. First method, object repository based test design, another descriptive programming. First I am taking object repository, object repository based test design. See, again in object repository based test design we have two methods. One is recording, another is keyword driven methodology. Without recording, generating tests manually using shared object repositories. Okay, first I am taking recording. Recording. Okay, first chapter as per our test or roadmap, record and run tests. Record and run tests. Okay, first what is recording? What is recording? Test recording. Next, what is test run or test execution? Synonyms, but HP most of the time used run term in their documentation. Run execution same. Next, recording modes. We have four recording modes in UFT. One is normal recording. Next, analog recording. Next, low level recording. Last one, insight recording. Insight recording. Okay, next, advantages of recording. Advantages of a recording. Next, disadvantages of recording. See, this is the chapter index. See, first, what is test recording? Observe, I am taking the new test. This is new test. Launch object repository, resources, object repository. Just a minute. Object repository blank, blank, only headings. Next, select record mode. Just a minute. Select record. Click OK. See, activate the dialog box. Enter agent name, any 4-digit value. Enter password, password fixed for this sample application, that is Mercury. Click OK button. Stop recording. Observe. What is the recording process? Steps for recording. First step, select record how to select record. Three possibilities na, one is
yes from the record menu,
record menu, record command, next or select record command. From the toolbar or use F6 shortcut key, anyone. Next, second step, click OK. After selection of recording, navigate the application, application under test, navigate the application. Next, at the end, just a minute, after completion of the navigation, stop recording. Next, what will happen? After recording, you can get two things. One is, see, after recording, first thing, UFT generates steps, or you can say statements for all user operations, or you can say user actions on EAUT. This is external process. Next, one more thing. UFT simultaneously, UFT stores objects information. See, for execution, object recognition is required. UFT stores objects information into object repository. This is after recording. See, final conclusion. What is recording process? See, UFT generates steps for every user action on EAUT simultaneously and stores objects information into object repository. See, this is the test recording process. Getting? Tell me, what is test recording?
UFT generates steps for every action on this test.
On AUT, UFT generates statements or steps for every user action on AUT, simultaneously stores object's information into object repository. Okay, that is okay. Test recording process. Next steps, follow the steps. First I am taking the new test, just launch object repository, confirmation blank, it is new test. Next follow the first step, select record command, click OK. I will explain these options. See, next, just a minute, first launch the application, otherwise you can launch application using script also. Using script also you can launch application. See, select record command, next navigate. Activate the dialog, enter agent name, enter password, click OK. Next, stop recording. Next, launch object repository, resources, object repository. Observe. Objects information stored. Total how many objects information? How many objects?
Three.
Login parent. Three child objects. Total four objects information. Total four objects information. Okay, observe in this dialog. In this dialog, how many objects are there? Forget about that flight image, that is static object which doesn't have any functionality. Remaining, how many objects available, including parent?
Five.
Six, including parent, six. Login is parent object, two edit box childs, three button childs. Total, one parent, five childs, six objects. But it's stored only, it stored only four objects. Why four objects? It didn't store cancel button and help button. Why?
Because we didn't click on that.
Yes, we didn't perform any operation on those buttons. Okay. See, this is about test recording. Okay, test recording.
So what is that system util dot run? When
that is launching statement. That is launching statement.
So sometimes I have seen invoke application.
Yes,
or something.
Alternate. That is also for launching application. Anyhow, that I will explain in types of objects in EFT chapter. System util is utility object. It is for launching applications. Instead of system util dot run, you can use invoke application. That is utility statement of EFT. Alternate. Hello?
Okay, I got it.
It is a launching statement. See, this is about test recording. Next, test run. Test run. How to conduct a test execution? Single test run. See, test run. For test run, put base state. Base state. What is base state? Required state for running the test. Observe, for this test, what is the base state? What is the base state for this test? Nothing. Base state means required state for running the test. What is the base state for this test? Pre-setup.
Nothing.
Yeah, from launching, it will execute. See, from launching, run the script. Launching and login. Just a minute. I'm taking the new test. Suppose in this test no launching statement. First I opened the application manually. Enter agent name. Enter password. Click OK button. Stop recording. What is the base state for this application? What is the base state for this test?
Activate the flight.
See, flight reservation dialog box. What is the base state for this test? Flight reservation dialog box. This one. This is the base state. Then select run. Then it will execute. Executing. Okay. Suppose if you don't put base state, what will happen? See here, base state is flight reservation dialog. I didn't launch that one. If I run this test, what will happen? It waits maximum 20 seconds. That is UFT default synchronization time. After 20 seconds, it will show error. Object not available. See, is waiting maximum. It can wait 20 seconds. That is default synchronization time. See, after 20 seconds showing error, cannot identify the object. Understand the concept? Base state. What is base state? Required state or setup for running the test. Observe. For this test, what is the base state?
Activate login window.
Yes. Login. Login dialog box. Yes, login dialog box. Base state. Login dialog box. Login dialog box, base state. Next step, select a run command. Select run command. Here also three possibilities. One is run menu, run, or you can use toolbar option or shortcut key. I think shortcut key F5. See, run F5. Next, test run process. What is test run process?
Test run process.
Suppose I put base state, run the script, it is executing. Execution over. Okay. This is plain test. We didn't insert any verification point, just plain test. What is test run process? Say, during test execution, UFT reads statements one by one. UFT reads statements one by one from the editor. And gets objects information. Objects information from the object repository. Object repository. Based on that information, performs operations on AUT. Based on that information, performs operations on AUT. This is the test run process. See, once again, during test execution, UFT reads statements or steps or instructions one by one and gets objects information from object repository. Based on that information, performs operations on AUT. Suppose statements available in EFT tool editor, but one of the object is not one of the object information is not available in object repository, then what will happen? It will show error. For example, see, in this test we work with four objects: login dialog box, agent name edit box, password edit box, and OK button. See, resources, object repository. I'm deleting this OK button. Delete. Yes. Now, if I run this script, what will happen?
This will show an error.
Error. Definitely. After executing three statements, for last statement, it will show error. Run the script. See, error. The OK win button object was not found in the object repository. Okay, just a minute. See, resources, object repository. Add that one. Don't concentrate on these commands. This we will discuss in object repository chapter. Now only focus on recording and playback. This time, one more object. See, in that editor, four statements available, four objects information required for executing those four statements. But in object repository, five objects available, one extra object information available. What will happen if I run this script? Will it show error or execute? Extra information in object repository. No issue. If any extra object information is there, no issue. See, it requires four objects information. Four objects information available. Extra information also available. Forget about extra information. Required information available. So definitely it will execute. Just a minute. Run the script. See, executing. See, observe here two scenarios in test run process. First, first scenario, one or more objects information not available in object repository. Next scenario 2, see extra information, extra objects, one or more extra information available in object repository. Then what will happen? First scenario, it won't execute now.
Yes, it won't execute.
Error. Second scenario, extra objects information available.
It will execute.
Execute.
Yeah, required is available then.
Yes. See, this is about test run or execution process. Observe, so far we discussed two topics. One is test recording, another is test run or execution. What is recording? It is a process of generating statements or steps for every user operation on AUT. Simultaneously stores objects information into object repository. Next, test run or execution. During test execution, UFT reads statements one by one from UFT editor and gets objects information from object repository. Based on that information, performs operations on AUT. Okay, na?
Okay. Yes.
Next, normal recording. What we did, that was normal recording only. See, what is normal recording? Observe. Normal recording. It records user mouse and keyboard operations based on objects. See. It records user mouse and keyboard operations based on objects. Otherwise you can say technical definition, it records user context sensitive operations based on objects. What is context sensitive operation? Individual operation, independent operation. In between two operations, break is there. Observe. First operation in this navigation, activate the dialog box. Over. Next, second operation, enter agent name. Over. Next, third one, enter password. Next, fourth one, click on OK button. All these are context sensitive operations. Opposite, continuous operations. See, one small drawback in this normal recording mode, it is unable to record continuous mouse operations. See drawback, small drawback, but remember whenever we use recording for test design, 99% we select normal recording mode only. Remaining modes rare use. See one small drawback. It doesn't record, continuous mouse operations. Continuous mouse operations like digital signatures, etc. Just a minute. Next, it is UFT default recording mode. See, it is UFT tool default recording mode. Why? Why normal recording is UFT tool default recording mode? Observe. Suppose I want to select analog recording or low level recording or insight recording. Go to record menu. Observe. Analog recording, low level and insight recording modes are in disabled state. First select normal recording. Then again, now you can select analog or low level or insight recording modes. Getting this point, why normal recording mode is default recording mode? Without selecting,
because the other
okay, put mute. See, reason, without selecting normal record mode, we can't select other modes. That's why it is default recording mode. Tell me, what is normal recording mode? 3 points I explained regarding normal recording mode.
It is a default recording mode. It doesn't it doesn't record the continuous
mouse operations. It doesn't record continuous mouse operations. That is a drawback. First, what is normal recording? It records user mouse and keyboard operations based on objects, or you can say it records user continuous mouse operation, it records user context sensitive operations based on objects. See, two definitions. It records user mouse and keyboard operations based on objects, or it records user context sensitive operations based on objects. Next one, small drawback. It doesn't record user continuous mouse operations. Example, digital signature. Next, it is default recording mode. Why? Without selecting normal recording mode, we can't select other modes. After selecting normal recording mode only, we can switch to other modes. Okay, just a minute. Here two options available. First, select recording. Here two for Windows applications. Here two options available. First option, record and run on any open Windows based application. Record and run, just a minute. See here two options in Windows environment. In web environment also two options. First concentrate on this Windows applications. Record and run test on any open Windows based application. If we select this first option, then it will record on any open Windows based application. Say, suppose mistakenly if you click on any other application, it will record that statements also. Observe. Suppose my application is flight reservation application. Mistakenly I clicked on paint application. It recorded operations on paint also. Observe. Record on two applications na?
Yes, yes sir. I got it.
Okay. Next, second option. Playing back also same. It will play back on these two applications. Just last 2 minutes. One more option is there. What is that option? Take new test.
So this option is not recommendable, sir. I mean, choosing.
Not recommendable. This is only recommendable. Okay. Okay. Next, second option, record and run. Okay, you can use second option also. No issue. Actually, whenever you install UFT for first time, it enables the second option. You can use second option also. Say, second option. What is second option? Record and run only on. Means here you can specify the application. You can provide the path of the application. Suppose I provided flight reservation application path. Okay. Then it will record statements only on that application. It ignores other applications. Observe. You no need to launch, it will launch. Say second option, if you specify second option, you can specify the path of the application also. After providing path of the application, it will launch the application during recording. Then it will record operations only on that specified application. It ignores other applications. See, launched, activate, enter agent name, enter password, next, activate paint window, open paint, no. Observe, it didn't record any operations on paint na, only on dialogue, login dialogue na.
Yes, yes sir.
Okay, we'll meet tomorrow same time.